the Easter mystery by the gift of the Holy Spirit. It is the Holy Spirit who makes us capable of proclaiming the risen Christ in our world today. We ask the prayers for all the sick, especially Francis Dunn, Donald Skip, Mrs. Hickey. We also ask your prayers for all who have died, especially Olga Figueroa, John Navy, and Eleanor Madden. And at this Mass, we pray in a special way for thanksgiving for Father Tim Soucy's 25th anniversary of ordination to the priesthood. Thank you.
Given me orders afterwards to stop by for help. I'm very serious. I got there, and she had made for me this beautiful white vestment with doves down the front in honor of the Holy Spirit. Me and my big mouth, I don't know enough to keep it shut sometimes. Well, that's beautiful, Mom, but I can't wear it this Sunday. It's Pentecost. You got to wear red. So she made this, and it's Monday.
As the Spirit prompted them.
staying in Jerusalem at the time, the devout Jews of every nation under heaven. These heard the sound and assembled a large crowd. They were much confused because each one heard these men speaking his own language. The whole occurrence astonished them. They asked in utter amazement, "Are not all of these men who are speaking Galileans? How is it that each of us hears them in his native tongue? We are Corinthians, Medes, Elamites. We live in Mesopotamia, Judea, Cappadocia, Pontus, the province of Asia, Phrygia, Pamphylia, Egypt, and the regions of Libya around Cyrene. There are even visitors from Rome, all Jews, or those who have come over to Judaism, Cretans and Arabs too. Yet each of us hears them speaking in his own tongue about the marvels God has accomplished." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus came and stood before them. Peace be with you, he said. When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. At the sight of the Lord, the disciples rejoiced. Peace be with you, he said again. As the Father has sent me, so I send you. Then he breathed on them and said, Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive men's sins, they are forgiven them. If you hold them back, they are held back. The Gospel of the Lord.
If you were to ask Father Mark or some of the people who work with me, they would tell you that I have not been myself for the last 3 or 4 weeks. To put it charitably, I have been preoccupied, I guess. In addition, of course, between pastor here at St. Bernard's and St. John's and St. Gabriel's, the school and all that, and particular problems related to St. Bernard's, we have gone through the experience this past month of seeing a good friend, Senior John Pendergast, in his last days of illness and his death. In addition to that, I've been, of course, concerned about this business of celebrating my 25th anniversary. And to say the least, I have been preoccupied with that, to the point of getting very nervous at the time. I was extremely nervous last week when we had to get up in front of our fellow priests at the General Assembly in Lake Placid. And I usually get up and tell lots of jokes, but I was not able to do so. I was too nervous. This preoccupation with self that comes with thinking about these 25 years, after a while it gets a bit tiresome. I was reminded of a great line from a good movie, Peaches, and I bet Bette Midler was in that. I think she played a character named Soucy Bloom, and she was an entertainer. Like many entertainers, she was very self-centered and talked about herself incessantly. Well, finally, one day, even she got a little tired of talking about herself, so she said, enough of talking about me, let's talk about you. What do you think of me? Business was kind of getting me down after a while, I guess. But you know, God is what God provides little things to kind of jolt us out of these preoccupations. Sometimes they give you a good bop right on the head. This time, for me, it was a very gentle thing. In fact, I don't think I even noticed it for what it was for 2 or 3 days. And it happened on Tuesday morning. I came over to read some of my office, pray in the office. And when I got here, the school children were here from St. Bernard's. They were practicing for the spring concert, which was on Wednesday evening. And I sat down back there, and Mrs. Smith, the first grade teacher, came back to talk to me. She said, Father, we have a little problem over in first grade. It seems they had just gone through their section on human sexuality. And in the course of that, first grade, one of the things that they learned at that level was that the proper place for having children was within the context of marriage. And they were a little upset because they had in their room now, in the classroom now, two rabbits, Oreo and Rosie. And they were a little upset. They were afraid that Oreo and Rosie might get messing around and start having little family funnies without benefit of clergy. Monday, tomorrow, I have to go over and bless the rabbits. But I interpreted that as God's way of very gently saying to me, well, now, Timothy, as important as you are, and as big a deal as this 25th is, there are one or two other small items going on in the universe. There are other things to be concerned about. And it helped me to reflect on my own priesthood, and the celebration today is more about priesthood than it is Timothy, at least I hope it is. And it seemed to me to be really great that fell on this feast of Pentecost, feast of the Holy Spirit coming to the apostles. Because when you get thinking about what this feast means and what priesthood means, they weren't very far apart at all. It seemed to me they're going in the same direction. First of all, when you get centered on yourself too much, and that's your whole point of your life, is yourself being me all the time, you come up empty-handed so often. But if you allow the Holy Spirit to fill that emptiness, what great gifts and what great wonders and what great things can happen because of that. And it seems to me that that is what priesthood is about. It's not just about my own salvation. It's not even just about me helping you with your own salvation, but it's about us together calling forth the gifts that all of us have. And it is the job of the priest, the duty of the priest, to bring some order to that. We receive the sacrament of holy order. We bring order to all these different gifts, that all these different people here. It's so wonderful today to have people from so many places gathered for this celebration. We had, just like the apostles did at Pentecost, we have people here from Lake Clear and from Indian Lake, from Champlain and from Saranac Lake, from Paul Smith and Watertown, Plattsburgh. We even have visitors from Ogdensburg, priests and deacons. It is marvelous that you are all here gathered to celebrate together with us. We're celebrating not just my gifts, but all of our gifts. And I'm very grateful for the last 25 years, especially for those times when I have been able to call forth and help call forth those gifts of all the people that I've tried to serve. And I throw myself at the confidently at the knees of the loving God for the times when I have failed to do so. I'm thankful for everything that has taken place these past 25 years, and I am so glad that I'm going to be able to begin the next 25 by tomorrow morning, blessing those rabbits.
Thank you.
gives to each one of us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, have the Spirit, and be with the
Spirit. In thanksgiving for the many blessings received through Father Tim's 25 years of priestly service, may he be filled with the goodness of the Lord for years to come. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, have the Spirit, and be with the Spirit.
Generous Father, we know that the Holy Spirit who you have sent will bring to you our deepest longings and prayers. We offer these prayers to your countenance in the name of Jesus, your Son and our Lord.
Amen.
Please join us in our offertory song, Rainbow number 706.
Thank you.
meaningful sacrifice by God our Almighty Father. Lord, may the Spirit who crowned us lead us into all truth and reveal to us the full meaning of this sacrifice. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Open your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Father, all powerful and ever living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks. Today, you sent the Holy Spirit on those marked out to be your children by sharing the life of your own Son. And so you brought the paschal mystery to its completion. Today we celebrate the great beginning of your church when the Holy Spirit made known to all peoples the one true God and created from the many human languages one voice to profess one faith. The joy of the resurrection renews the whole world while the choirs of heaven sing forever to your glory.
Remember our brothers and sisters who have gone to
share eternal life with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, with the apostles, and with all the saints who have done your will throughout the ages. May we praise you in union with them and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
I'd like to invite the children now to come up and help lead us in prayer with Jesus himself.
Thank you.
takes away the sins of the world. Happy are we who are called to gather at his table. Lord, I am not
Thank you. 6 to be your bed.
Thank you.
within us the vigor of your Spirit and protect the gifts you have given to your church. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank all of you for gathering here today to celebrate with me and my family and friends. Especially thank my dear friends and new friends for coming to join us in the celebration. A very, very special thank you to the choir and the children's choir.
Thank you.
school for the Lord. But I bought my college man picture.
Priesthood. Before he was a priest, he always said he was a regular person. I don't know what all that means, but we've known each other for about over 30 years, and he deserves this honor and respect today because he is a very good person. Good person, good priest. Well, I can tell you some great stories about Father Soucy, and I will. Eventually, as we get into this, as we begin this nice occasion honoring him on his 25th, it's nice to be here in the cafeteria. He's probably the most hospitable person I know. Very. A man of hospitality makes people feel welcome at the rectory, as everybody knows. So as we begin this meal, we call upon Father Mark Riley, the parochial vicar here in St. Martin's, to say grace for us. And would you please stand, and right after the grace, we're going to have the toast.
Celebrate 25 years of priesthood with Father Tim. We thank God for the many blessings he has given the church too in this priestly life. Now, 25 years ago, Bishop Verzana laid his hands on Father Tim's head and bestowed on him, by the power of the Holy Spirit, the sacrament of holy orders. Nearly 2,000 years before then, another bishop, St. Paul, imposed hands on another man named Timothy, bestowing upon him this special grace. The words he wrote to Timothy then can well apply to our Father Tim today. I thank God, the God of my forefathers, whom I worship with a clear conscience whenever I remember you in my prayers, as indeed I do constantly, night and day. For this reason, I remind you to stir into flame the gift of God bestowed when my hands were laid on you. The spirit God has given us is no cowardly spirit, but rather one that makes us strong, loving, and wise. And so we pray. Lord, we praise and thank you today for the strong, loving, and wise shepherd you have given us in Father Tim. Remain with him today and every day, and continue to bless us all. Bless this meal and those who have prepared it. Bless all those who played a part in Father Tim's path to the priesthood and the journey of these past 25 years. May we all join together one day at the eternal celebration in your holy presence, where you reign as Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Amen. Make sure everybody has a little wine in your glass or soda or something.
Oh, you want the wine.
I'd like to introduce now Father Jake Crable, retired priest of the diocese, moving toward the podium very soon. And he will give the toast this afternoon.
Will the ushers now take up the next collection? This is a toast. Here's to Father Tim. Long may he wave for the land of the free, and that all you can save. All hail this great sport and this fine competitor, as he is inspired to say to his noble and friendly priest companion, that's good, Jake. Pick it up. yes. Here is a toast to Father Tim with his happy and joyous grin as he says to his faithful priestly companion, here, I'll take that. This is my treat. Indeed, do we salute Father Tim on this great occasion of his silver jubilee, for he is indeed a gentlemanly priest and a priestly gentleman. Tim, may the wind be always at your back. And may the road rise to meet you. And may the good Lord always keep you in the palm of his hand. And may the good Lord grant you many, many more years of happiness in his priesthood. Hear, hear.
Hear, hear.
Thank you very much, Jake. Nicer outside, and it's really cleared up good, so we hope everybody enjoys the meal, and we'll be back at you at the end. Thank you.
Middle daughter, Mary Kay, and up to Dan. Mary Kay is very pregnant. And we're going to have my first great niece or nephew, you know? Well, we'll be happy whatever it is. Say goodbye to them on their way back to the Copenhagen. Any, louder? Okay.
permission for us to remove our jackets if you wish. Thank you, Chester.
Some people are leaving. Father Soucy said, why don't you move it right along? So here I am. I'd like to sing one verse of Father Soucy's favorite song. Can you join in singing with me?
We are one in the Spirit. We are one.
And I thought it was a nice Tim's picture. It's down there when he was first ordained. Wow. Wow. And they're holding it up. I weigh the same as I did when I was ordained. I didn't say it all. How we've all grown over the years, in many different ways. But he's a man of many talents. He's a gardener, he's a bicyclist, he's a good cook, he's a cross-country skier, and he's been known to play a little golf. He's got a couple of Father Tim stories. They're real stories, they really happened. My mother will clarify them. If you want to know who this lady is right here, this is my mother, Tessiana Gaffney. Okay. She said, nobody knows me here at that table, so I just introduced her to everybody so everybody will know. It was funnier in the car, wasn't it? I'm glad I really told that right there. You can have the mic too. There you go. When you start heckling the MC, you know you're in trouble. I like you too. One of my favorite Father Soucy stories is when you think you know somebody, we've been hanging out for over 30 years, there's always something new to discover about someone. And when I first came to Lake Placid 3 years ago, I used to call the rector here, just called St. Bernard's, a little bit after lunch, about 1 o'clock. And Nancy LeBombard, who works at the rectory here, would answer the phone, and I would say, "Is Father Soucy there?" And she would say that he was at summer devotions. And then you've heard this, but I like this story. And I said, don't say what it is. You know what it is. Anyhow, and I thought, gee, wasn't that great? After lunch, maybe they're saying the rosary or reading the Bible. Seriously, I thought that was great. I never thought anything of it. And 2 or 3 more times, Nancy didn't know me because I was over in Lake Placid. She didn't know me when I first came there. And she said, "Father Soucy is at summer devotion." I thought that was great. So about a month later, at the end of August, I said to Tim, I says, I called a few times after lunch, 3 or 4 times, Nancy said that you were at summer devotions. And what do you have? Do you have a little prayer thing going on after lunch? And he kind of smiled and he said, summer devotions is golf. God, he's clever, isn't he? He can make, he's very holistic. Everything in his life is all tied in with the spiritual, even golf. You should hear some of the words he says on the golf course. Very, very biblical. I don't know what the hell Bible he's reading, but I don't know. Anyhow, there. One other story that, as you know, thought it, me, every Friday night when we taught at IHC, I was looking at Kelly and Mary Kay and Jamie, Tim, Bobby's daughters, they're all grown up now, and we taught them at IHC back in the 80s. Tim and I taught right across from each other, kitty corner to each other, and my God, were we loud when we taught together. But, and I forgot the story that I was going to tell because I started talking about those three girls.
What is it?
Must be that roast beef. Oh yeah, that's the story. Well, every Friday night, we used to go out for supper. You probably find it hard to believe that we went out for a lot of meals together. Just looking at us visually, you can probably see that. And one particular, when I came up here to Lake Placid, we've been known to go out to eat every once in a while. We were sitting in a restaurant, I don't know where it was, here or Lake Placid, and a parishioner from St. Bernard's came up and said, started talking to us, and, oh, it's nice to see you. And they said, do you climb mountains? Said to Father Soucy, and I addressed the question to Tim, and said, do you climb mountains? Of course, we are active. We do cross-country ski, we play a lot of golf, and we're not sitting around a lot. And Tim said, yeah, he said, I'm a 46er. You shouldn't laugh that hard. And the person looked at us and kind of sarcastically kind of smiled, you know, like, yeah, okay, yeah, you guys are 46ers, all right. Tim says, yeah, I'm a 46er. He said, Father Gaffney and I have been in at least many times over 46 restaurants in the High Peaks area. There has been many a mountain of fettuccine carbonara that we've come. One of Tim's favorite expressions is, golly, I'm full. It must have been something I ate. There we go. Well, without any further ado, I would like to introduce the main man of the day, Father Timothy J. Soucy.
Mostly what I'd like to do is introduce some of the people who make this, this party a success. And I'd like to start with some of the parishioners that I have been fortunate enough to serve with. And I'd like to start with my very first parish. Oh, I better wait. John must have been to the bathroom, didn't he?
John's missing, is he? Oh, there he is, there he is. John and Joey Brazell from Indian Lake, stand up. Champlain. So if they would stand up, all the Champlainers, they would stand up. And Lake Clear and Paul Smith. Anybody here from Lake Clear and Paul Smith, please stand up. Short, right there. I really appreciate Lowell coming because Lowell hates the crowd, I'll tell you. So I really appreciate him coming. And our good friend Bernice Longshore. Now, Mike already introduced his mother.
Tassiana Gaffney. And Tassiana, besides being good friends with Mike, I'm good friends with her. Even if I didn't know him, I'd be good friends with him. She's a great lady. And I'm not the only one celebrating an anniversary this year, 25th anniversary. We had Father John Murphy at Mass today. He had to go back to Augsburg for another celebration down there. But I'm especially happy to have with us today Father Stephen Grotto, who's pastor of St. Alexander's in Morrisonville, a classmate of mine. And I think you probably already know Father Michael Gaffney, J. Michael Gaffney, pastor of St. Agnes in Wisconsin. The four of us, Father Monsignor Murphy and Father Grotto and Father Gaffney and myself, will be taking a little trip for our anniversary. We're going to Scotland and England, September 10th. Father Grotto is right there. We're going to do a little call devotion. I'd like to introduce some other members of my family. In the back, oh, there's my sister Bobby over here, and some of her family is kind of over there. So everybody from my sister Bobby's family, raise your hand. And I'm also very appreciative of all my priest friends that came here. One of the first priests that I worked with before I was ordained, and he doesn't look anywhere near old enough for this to be true, but it's Father Bill Minch. I worked with him in Sackett and Henderson for two wonderful summers. This long, did he? Is he still here? Still here? Oh my God, he's still here. Oh my God. This is amazing. That's a great man. He is such an inspiration. I can't tell you. That man is so interested in life and in golf. And got those. Hey, those are two of the most important things in the world, life and golf. You got those things down. Left, huh? He's a great man, he really is. And I appreciate every single one of you being here with us today. Oh, wait a minute, I just see somebody else to whom I owe an awful lot. I was in Watertown for 11 years of my priesthood, 9 years, I guess, and seven of the most wonderful of those I spent at St. Patrick's in Watertown. And someone who helped me develop from the person you saw in that picture to the person I am today is Miss Hilda Quayle, right there. Actually, I did better with my weight with Hilda than any person I've ever been with. Her meals were so good, I didn't even have to eat between meals. She's a great lady. So I thank you for coming, and I hope you've had a good time and continue to enjoy yourselves. God bless.
We certainly don't have to leave, but we'd just like to have a little closing prayer and thought from Father Louis Gardner, a good friend of Father Tim's. Father Gardner.
I'm going to be short because I've got to go to the bathroom. What reminds me when I was here. Oh, God's mouth. As here with Monsignor Zimmerman back in 1959, he was here 4 years. Pius was just opened up. It was the first year. So it seems like coming home. And Minton, before we say the blessing for the Thanksgiving, I don't want to say anything about sin too bad, because I'm coming up here to live. And you might tell me I can't come.
That's why we asked you, Lord.
That's what I figured. You're going, I found out today why you asked me. You're going to Scotland. Almighty God for him, for his priestly ministry, for all the help that he's been to you and to me down through the years. He's been very good to me. I lived next door. When he was in Champlain, I paid his bills. They had no money and we had all kinds. So Tim has been very good to me and I appreciate it very much. So we thank our Heavenly Father for his ministry, for his priesthood, for his compassion towards us. And he taught me this little prayer. So I'll say it to him now in thanksgiving. Thank you, Tim, for caring. Thank you for sharing. But most of all, thank you for being you.
Worked so wonderfully on the kitchen and for the dinner today.
Yeah.
The crew who did the reception over at the rectory earlier. All these beautiful decorations. You see. Are you here, Shirley? She's not here, is she?
Granddaughter.
By the way, those decorations are taken home for the person at your table who will admit to being the oldest. Thank you.